Good morning, everybody.
Good morning,
everyone. This Christmas morning, we have a slightly different service, and we hope that you've been able to join us in the comfort of wherever space you may be in right now. We have a little take a look at our communion table that has different offerings for us. And for our Jewish friends, we have the Hanukkah burning today, of course, the seventh and almost the last day tonight. Marks the last day of Hanukkah, and that candle will be lit at that time. Mary and Joseph last night came to the manger, and here they are with the baby Jesus therein at this time today. Welcome, one and all, no matter how you may have arrived at this place, either in person or through the electronic medium from wherever you're watching, and we know people are watching from Cambridge, from Kingston, from Georgetown, and from Milton as well. From Ottawa, we also have viewers tuning in. Please make yourself comfortable in a casual manner this Christmas morning of 2022. Merry Christmas to you, Heather.
And Merry Christmas to you, Charlie.
Did you get what you wanted last night?
Oh, I always do.
Oh, gosh. We won't go there and do that any further.
Too much information.
It is our hope that you have joined us this morning to renew and strengthen the time-tested threads of traditional wonder that light up the world and are not dimmed by the passage of the generations. These threads of Christmastide connect us with the memories of what has been, the memories that still are, right there, deep down inside of every one of us. Beloved in Christ, it is our duty and delight to hear again, as we did last evening, the message of the angels, and to revel in heart and mind our short and all too brief residency right here with Mary and Joseph in Bethlehem. Therefore, let us recall the tale of the loving purposes of God from our first days and even unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this house of prayer glad with the carols of praise. Let us pray to him for the needs of the whole world and all his people for peace on earth that he came to save, for love and unity within the church, for goodwill among all peoples, and particularly at this time, let us remember those who have not the abundance that we take for granted, those who wrestle daily with the cold of the streets, the frigid grasp of war, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick and those that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and little children, and all who do not know Jesus or do not know how to love him. Let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in greater light, the multitude which no one can number, those whose hope was in the Word made flesh and with whom in this Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. Let us humbly offer these prayers and praises to the throne of heaven as we worship together. And a few words of greeting, a Christmas gift that is golden, written by one of our new parishioners, Lance Cole. A memory of our journeys and how they're often swift reminds us that your presence is the present and the present is the gift. Amen.
Thank you.
us join our hearts together in prayer this Christmas morning. Let us pray. Stir our hearts into action, O God, as we have prepared the pathway upon which you shall trod, and have opened our hearts to your figurative birth this Christmastide. We rejoice that you have come to speak peace to your people and call upon us to turn our hearts to you. It is our quest to find hope in your presence within our world. In you, O God, our souls find silence and peace. As you sought us through the Christ child born in a manger, so let us seek your will with the simplicity and humility of heart. Keep us within the paths that you walk, so that we may love and know justice, and receive with gratitude your heavenly gift of Jesus the Christ, the one whom we follow. We ask that your saving grace and splendid glory will dwell in all the earth through Jesus Christ, whose day is with us now. We give all glory, laud, and honor. Amen. Friends, let us pray. As we rest on this day of birth of the light of the world, we give thanks for the gift of peace and the warmth of memories that this time may bring. We are grateful for the gifts with which we have been provided and express our earnest wish for a year of peace and goodwill amongst all. Help us rightly to remember the birth of Jesus, that we have shared with the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and the worship of the Magi who shall yet come forth. Close the doors of hate and open the doors of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from our biases and prejudice through the blessing that Christ brings. and teach us to be caring people with compassionate hearts. May this Christmastide bring us grateful thoughts, health and happiness, renewed energy to walk boldly into a new year with Jesus at our side. This we ask in the name of the one whose coming and whose birth we celebrate. Amen.
Well, how do you say many different things that rush into your head and your mind on Christmas Day? There are so many different things to talk about. Last night we mentioned with the children on our Christmas Eve service the colors of Christmas, of the tiny animals that may just have been in the manger when the baby Jesus was born. But today we have another thought, and we focus on the baby Jesus. And the question we asked is, where is the baby? Well, you might say right here in the manger, but let's just hear what some words might give us. In a few hours, Christmas for some will be over. The presents will all have been opened, and in many homes, the decorations lose their luster. Too many needles are falling from the tree, and thoughts of putting them away start to materialize and dance around with the realm of possibility thinking. Though it is possible, if we strain and listen very carefully, we still can hear it, the faint memory, a leftover echo of all the razzmatazz, the excitement that came before and led into the night, Christmas Eve, the birth of that unique baby in the manger. There's a lingering presence, I am sure, a leftover essence that yet hangs suspended in the air this Christmas morning. Perhaps you can even feel it enough to give you goosebumps or send a shiver down your spine. Since this is the time of year when nostalgia rules the roost and nobody dares act like Scrooge and complain about it, let's give in to it, if but for a brief moment longer. Reach out, if you will, and grasp one of those sugar plums of memory that hang suspended within the space of those memories of Christmases past. It won't hurt a thing. Assurance be known, you can't get the same ambience when you order through the internet from Amazon or at Walmart either, or the Dollarama. They just don't have it. The savory sensation of Christmas morning of which I speak is a combination of things, a magical distillation of anticipation, memories, hopes, fears, joys, deflation, and sadness. If you walked into any one of the myriad of coffee shops in our city, and the person behind the counter asked, "What would you like to order?" and you said, "I'd like to order whatever I'm smelling," you might think, "Oh, we can't do that, sir," would be told. What you smell is a combination of everything we have. It would break your visa limit if you did that. The same is true with Christmas morning. What you sense, what you smell, what you see and hear, what you feel at this very moment is a combination of everything you have experienced this Christmas season and all the Christmas seasons that have passed into our memory banks. It's what you bring to the celebration of Christ's birth that makes the experience. The state of your heart, your soul, right now is the resulting product, the sum total of it all. The sad part of it all is that we know it won't last, but we sense it right now, and we want to savor it for all it's worth. At least, well, the moment lasts, and that's all it is, just a moment. We want to celebrate the sense of peace and hope that comes especially at this time of year. One of our favorite authors, Barbara Brown Taylor, in her book, Home by Another Way, puts it this way. She says that Christmas Eve and Christmas Day are times when the membrane between heaven and earth is so thin you can almost see through it. Last night and this morning are the standards against which we measure all time. Our church's sanctuary, so beautifully decorated for the season, had become last night a waiting room. We found ourselves pacing the floor nervously until we got news that the baby was born. That's where we were, Christmas Eve. This morning, Christmas Day, finds us outside the window in the nursery, looking through that window and making googly faces at the little one, the tiny one wrapped in soft blankets, safe and secure from all alarms and in a sense of wonder, with a nervous twitch of angst, how safe, we wonder, is he really is. How long his new life will last. That waiting in itself can come in different forms. Author Bob Baker, ordained priest and science fiction writer, interestingly, suggests, whether we like it or not, Christmas is a time machine, and this place is our Bethlehem, to which we have hauled the hopes and the fears of all our years and laid them in the manger. For that reason alone, it's good for us not to make this story, that we know almost by heart into a fairy tale. It was hardly that. If our hopes are dependent on the marketplace or in the fairy tale, we've not only missed the point, we've deluded ourselves in the process and set ourselves up for a very big disappointment. End of that quote. There is a certain degree to which, even on Christmas weekend, we have to deal with the reality of the story and not just the fantasy of it. There were no talking animals, no drummer boys at the birth of Jesus, no players, sorry Ross, no players of the bagpipe either. It was what it was, and we need to acknowledge that. The story is what it is. There are those in our community that have to deal with their own reality at Christmas, and that's hard enough. For some, Christmas is, in the words of the late Harry Emerson Fosdick, the burdened season, or in the paraphrased words of Charles Schulz in the Charlie Brown's Christmas, the season of the great humbug. For some of us, it's a hard time of the year. There's an empty chair to deal with, a stocking that wasn't hung, a presence that just isn't there where it should be, and Christmas is lonelier than it's been in a long, long time. For some of us, we have endured the onslaught of the season so many times and pasted on that festival smile with the corners of our mouths raised Mona Lisa-like, and we have placed a hardened, calloused, protective, creative defense upon our hearts so that the real truth cannot penetrate deeply into our lives. But taking a note from Mary in this narrative, we might consider responding to the traditional Christmas message by making it fresh in our hearts, by pondering it in a new way. Whilst researching on the internet for thoughts for living for Christmas Day 2022, I came across a rather different Christmas card greeting. One card said, "Christmas is just plain weird. What other time of year do you sit around staring at a dead tree in your living room and eating candy out of your stocking?" There are some things about the whole Christmas story that are also a tad unusual and need to be taken with a pound of salt. Not a grain, a pound of salt. A virgin teenager gets pregnant, Caesar's tax and census, the trip to Bethlehem to be registered with no room in the inn, a baby born in the stable, and there are more on this list. For a non-Christian, or someone who is part of the 50% of the unchurched population, it's all too incredible to believe. Whilst we have heard the story so many times, I wonder how many of us have actually ever stopped to ponder these things in our hearts. C.S. Lewis, well-known writer, said, "We don't need to be told new ideas so much as we need to be reminded of old truths." The baby whose birthday we celebrate at Christmas is easily hidden beneath the piles of tradition and cultural observances that are attendant to the season. Just like so many coats thrown on the bed upstairs by all the guests that have come a-visiting, it is incumbent upon us to enter every Advent and thence through all of Christmastide by asking, "Where's the baby? Where's the baby?" before throwing our coat onto the pile. And that's the last gift we open this morning, the question, "Where's the baby?" For it is the Magi with whom we yet journey in search of the truth, who are on a vital quest throughout the year to find the Christ born again in each one of us at Christmastide. All we need to do is look at our partner or our neighbor, and yet easier still, look in a mirror, and we will have found the truth. And looking back at us, we will see a vestige the face of the child of the star. Amen. our service today in wrapping paper of gold, as the memories are golden. And I finish with Lance's greeting, which is also a benediction, a memory of our journeys and how they're often swift, reminds us that your presence in the present is the gift. Amen. God bless everybody. Merry Christmas 2023 and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
2023. Merry Christmas. Whoops. Merry Christmas 2022. Boy, are we having a good time when time flies fast. And Happy New Year 2023. Got it right.